Well, that's a beautiful new addition to the Wildflower Center. We're very excited about that. And joining me right now from the Lady Bird Johnson Wildflower Center is Andrea DeLong-Amaya. It's great to see
Hello.
You again.
Thank
Welcome
you.
Back to the program. Busy time for the Wildflower Center.
It is very much.
Well, you have the grand opening of the Family Garden, which yes. is everybody on pins and needles. But it's also time for the gardens on tour.
It is. Yes, we have things back to back. The first weekend, which is May 4th, is going to be the grand opening for the public for the Lucy and Ian Family Garden. And the following Saturday, May 10th, will be the garden tour.
So back to back weekends, all planned out for the whole entire community, courtesy of the Wildflower.
That's right. I'm going to keep you entertained.
Well, I think you will. I think you will. The family garden is going to be quickly.
It's a lot of fun.
I think the public is going to embrace it.
And it's not just for kids. That's a very important piece, that it's really going to be fun for anybody who goes out there.
There's a kid inside of each of us,
I
like to believe.
Absolutely.
And I think that we would all enjoy that space. But gardens on tour, we want to dive in and give people an idea about what's going on. Let's just start talking about one of the gardens. There's one out on Bee Caves Road that is going to be part of the tour this year that looks absolutely stunning.
It is. I'll just give you a little bit of overview. This is our 10-year anniversary of the garden tour.
Okay.
And so what we've done is all of the gardens that we have on the tour this year have been featured in previous tours, so this is a retrospective.
Or greatest hits, perhaps?
Sort of, although there's some greatest hits like your garden, sir, that don't exist anymore, so we can't have those. But we're calling it a retrospective.
Okay.
So this is one that was on the garden tour in 2011.
Okay.
And it's a beautiful garden. It's 22 acres, the entire property. Around the house is elaborate gardens.
Wait, 22 acres of garden?
not of gardens. The property is 22
acres.
So around the house is beautiful gardens.
Great.
Tate is a wonderful plantsman. He has a great collection of natives and non-natives.
Right.
He also has a business doing landscaping. He's a landscape architect, which is interesting because he gets cast off materials from projects that he's incorporated into his landscape. And, you know, that could be a mess sometimes, but he's really great with it. It looks really cool.
Yeah.
Lots of neat little ways he's put things together.
Strong bones in this garden.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Lots of
fun.
Lots of strong architecture in this, it appears. Beautiful stone planters.
Great stonework, yeah.
Yeah.
And their native plant gardens, their vegetable gardens, their little water feature. There are a little bit of trails that will be accessible on the garden tour. So, yeah, we're looking forward to having that one on the tour again.
You could spend some time in this one, it looks
yeah,
and really wander around. So that's on Bee Caves Road. Now, if people want to participate in the tour, it's easy to do. They just go online and find out where to buy tickets.
Yeah, we'll have all of our information on our website, including where you can get tickets. People can just show up at any of the gardens the day of the tour and buy tickets per garden. Or you could get a wristband that'll let you into all the gardens.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a map that's on our website, so people will know where to go to find those first gardens.
Wonderful Mother's Day tradition. So bring mom.
Yes.
It is one of the, I think it's a very cool way to treat mom.
It's a great way, yeah.
Yeah.
Moms or, you know, even friends. And it's just a great way to remember when that is. And who doesn't want to go see gardens?
Right.
It's a great time of year, too.
There's another garden that's going to be featured. It's on Maury Hollow. And this is a native plant garden that's been a native plant garden for quite some time, I understand.
Yeah, I don't remember how old the garden itself is, but it's 20-plus years old.
Mm-hmm.
And for the people who really like to see the smaller, more manageable-sized gardens, like a normal person-sized garden.
I like the sound of that, normal-sized
person.
Yeah,
this is one. And actually, it's a twofer. They're two houses next to each other. And the owners have collaborated together in using lots of native plants in their small gardens. And it's a great way to see how people are using a small space and making it very comfortable, livable space.
And I love the idea of neighbors sharing a garden where one flows right into the other.
Yeah, you know, it's cool that they've collaborated that way.
Yeah.
And they back up to the Balcones Canyonlands Preserve. And so one of the main things that both of them have is wanting to accommodate wildlife by using organic methods in their gardening and also the plantings to attract wildlife, too.
All right. Well, one of the things I think that will be on everybody's mind this year is with the continuation of the drought and the condition of the lakes, and people are going to be, I would think, are clamoring for information about these xeric native gardens.
Mm-hmm, absolutely. Yeah. And, you know, if you can use native plants that are adapted to your area, you really don't have to use as much water as you would if you were using non-native plants.
Well, and this now people can go and see how these gardens have fared over the decades,
exactly.
Which is really cool.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, the next garden we're going to focus on is on Rock Cliff. Mm-hmm. And tell me a little bit about this one.
Yeah, this is about a 2-acre size garden. And it's a nice combination of sun and shade areas. There's a stream that goes, the illusion is that it starts in the front yard, goes under the house, and comes out the backside. The backside is very steep, so little warning that it is steep territory in the mm-hmm. back. But it makes this beautiful series of waterfalls. There are 14 waterfalls going down the back.
Wow.
Beautiful stonework, all mm-hmm. native plants, about 200 species, so it's a really good diversity, mm-hmm. condensed selection of native plants.
I've been to this garden, and it's some of the most beautiful stonework I've ever seen.
Yeah,
and there's a grotto feature not to be missed.
Yes, a nice little grotto. The front yard, there's a maidenhair fern wall. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, there's lots of beautiful things to see there.
And again, a mature garden, too. So, mm-hmm. one that is settled in, and people can see how it's fared over time.
Yeah, I think that one they started building in 2007. So, it's, you know, and it was nestled in with a bunch of mature live oaks. And mm-hmm. So, it looks very settled in.
Okay. Mm-hmm. The next garden we're going to talk about is Old Stonehenge. Mm-hmm. And it's the street. It's not the garden.
Stonehenge, yes, it's Stonehenge.
It's not a circle of stones. But right. tell us a little bit about this space.
Yeah, this is another one that is, I think, exclusively locally native plants, mm-hmm. like Travis County local.
Okay.
And it's a really local. Good example of how, you know, if you pick the right plants for the right conditions, mm-hmm. you really have very little maintenance. It's a really good example of sustainability. This one and the previous one, the Rock Cliff Garden that we mm-hmm. just mentioned, they're using plants that are adapted. And it's what's interesting about both of those gardens is they did not use soil amendments or fertilizers. And that's something that, you know, most gardeners, like, you can't have enough compost in your soil.
Right.
But if you're using locally adapted native plants in the right kind of soil, mm-hmm. you don't have to do that. And you can see how beautiful and lush these gardens are without that extra added effort.
Right. Well, that is, I think, a really important point about the soil work. And I know that some of the people who specialize in these kinds of gardens really are key on that. They collect native soils.
Yeah, right.
I want to know what the source is, Frank.
Yeah. Well, this is interesting. This is in Westlake, and uh-huh. when they just preserved the landscape. They didn't bring in mm-hmm. any soil, which is good for keeping weeds out, too.
Oh, there you go. Mm-hmm. Very important factor. Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, the next garden is on Stratford Drive, mm-hmm. and this is another really special space.
Yeah, another model of sustainability. Mm-hmm. The home is a LEED certified building, and that is a good testament of the commitment that the homeowners mm-hmm. had to their landscape and wanting to make their landscape sustainable as well. So really focusing on using native plants, eliminating a lot of invasive species that were on the property.
Big focus on art in this garden.
Yes, there's some beautiful art, rainwater harvesting system, mm-hmm. a stormwater management system that feeds into the terraced gardens in the backyard. Mm-hmm. So it's a really good study in how these folks have done a really good job with water conservation,
right.
as well as using native plants and making a really beautiful garden.
And of course, as always, part of the tradition of the day is the Wildflower Center itself is mm-hmm. part of the tour.
It is.
So people can visit these five beautiful spaces mm-hmm. and then swing by. And will they get to see the new family garden?
Yes, the family garden will be open.
Okay.
So that's a good treat.
Okay. So yes. Just a real quick reminder, the date again is Mother's Day weekend.
Yes, May 10th, Saturday before Mother's Day.
Okay.
And it's from 9 to 5. And all the details are on our website, wildflower.org.
Right. Mm-hmm. And one of the things, photography is allowed?
All except one of the gardens allows photography this year,
okay.
yes.
Okay, well, that's mm-hmm. that's pretty good.
It is pretty good. And the one that doesn't, it's still worth seeing. It's really a beautiful garden.
Right. So, you know, and again, my favorite thing about garden tours is meeting the gardeners. And I know that in many of these spaces, folks will probably have that opportunity.
Yes. Most of the time, either the homeowners or the designers will be there. We'll have Wildflower Center staff there to also talk about plants and plant lists. Yes. That's the fun part.
It's a great addition to the day. People really can learn something on this tour. So that's special. Thanks again for being
a part of our interest.
always interested in what the Wildflower Center is doing. Thank you so much for being a part of the program. Coming up next, it's Daphne.